Refinery 29, I am John Norris. Summer 2014 is here, and I think it is safe to say that one of the most anticipated records of that summer is called Sorry I'm Late. It comes from the lovely and amazing Cher Lloyd, who joins us, and it's good to see you and meet you.
Good to see you.
Sorry I'm Late, so that title.
I decided on the title before I knew that it was going to be pushed back.
Was the record done quite a long time ago, and it's just
been held up? Yeah, I'd learned so much more about myself and knew a lot more about the music industry. It just didn't quite line up.
With your previous label, where you were just like, enough, I've got to do something that's more my own thing.
The music has to come first for me. So if there is a situation where someone is putting a roadblock in my way, then I have to eliminate that roadblock. My fans want new material from me all the time, and I want to provide that for them. So to have those struggles with, you know, people that I work with can be quite difficult. But we all want the same thing. Yeah, it's becoming a lot more exciting now.
It can't have been an accident that the one tattoo that's most visible, the album cover, is the one that says, all you have is your soul.
This is a Tracy Chapman song. Nice. And growing up, my mom used to play it on repeat. Mm-hmm. And it took me years and years as a kid to understand what the song was about.
You've got a writing credit on about half the tracks, is that
right?
Yeah. So how did that work?
It was, you know, a collaboration. And that's why I feel that the album completely represents me now.
Sirens is, as are a number of the tracks on the album, a product of the Swedes, you might say, right? When you heard the song, did you think it was something special?
Most definitely. I kind of had to have it. Mm-hmm. I had to, because it brought back a certain emotion that I hadn't really thought about in years, you know, from being back in my hometown and in our old house and going through crazy situations. Just brought something back, and I think when you get a feeling like that, it's got to be worth something.
The video, as different a sound as the song is, I don't think that any of us anticipated a video quite as dark as we got. How did the idea and sort of your comfort level with bringing something that was based on something that happened in your own life to a music video?
Well, it was kind of strange for me because, you know, we had talked about a video and, you know, everyone was throwing all of these ideas around. So I spent the day with a pen and a piece of paper and I wrote the treatment. Because I just thought, well, if we're going to have a cool video and a video that's going to stand out from the rest, then it needs to come from me.
Does that episode in your life, which happened, I guess, when you were 5?
I can't really remember how old I was.
Yeah.
I mean, the thing about these situations is that, you know, when you give people an insight into, like, your childhood, things can get really blown out of proportion.
Because it's not meant to be an actual recreation of what happened.
No, it wouldn't be fair to my parents to say, this is exactly what happened.
Right. That
was not the point of the video. It was more or less just bringing up that emotion to let people see something that was a little dark and to let them realize that I didn't just wake up one day and have hair and makeup and be walking around New York with a brand new album.
Congratulations on this record. It is truly a step up and it's just some amazing tracks, and I hope everybody's discovered, and if they haven't, they will soon. Thanks so much.
Thank you.